It's the Richie Antipuna Show. With me, Heather Barton. Richie.
Ready? Welcome to Richie Antipuna Show.
Welcome to Richie Antipuna.
This is the Richie Antipuna Show.
Hi, I'm Heather Barton, and this is
the Richie Antipuna Show. Well, in today's economy, with the gas prices and shit going up, food prices going up, utilities going up, people shit getting cut up and shit, people getting real desperate. And like I always say, when people get desperate, they do desperate things. So they resort to crime and other things like that, and seek unconventional methods, which include scams that in the long run cost the people who are the target more money because they think they're getting a break when something falls off the truck and whatnot. It's like on Craigslist, they have them things with the reshipping items with put this check in your account and send me money and blah, 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 and the other work at home schemes and it all leads to like the identity theft shit. So just to protect yourself, just educate yourself. You know, use good common sense. If it sounds too good to be true, it probably is. And now you're supposed to say that. You don't even know what you say. You argued with me this morning and you don't even know what the fuck you don't know.
I was listening to you, Jack. Yeah.
Come on.
Well, when all the prices go up with the gas and the food and everything, do the prices of drugs go up?
Absolutely.
How do they work that? Because they don't charge more. If it's a $10 bag, it's a $10 bag. So
what happens is you get the same amount, but it's just cut more. That's why in our previous broadcast when we said the overdoses are down, that's why I said, because the shit ain't as potent as it used to be.
What are they?
So it actually does affect everything.
Cleaning products?
I don't know. Rat poison. All kind of dumb shit.
Rat poison?
Yeah.
And they don't die from rat poison?
No. They don't die from it.
I'm so glad I don't do drugs.
Yeah, me too. But at any rate, like, kids these days are, even adults now, are resorting to, like, household to get high on, sniffing different household products. And the big thing now is that bath salt. I don't know what it's called.
Bleach. When I clean with bleach, I get high. I hate bleach.
You huffing bleach?
It stinks. It burns my nose.
Get you high, you're saying?
Pretty much.
Wow.
That's why I don't clean.
Yeah, I don't know the name of the bath salt, but that's the new thing they're cutting.
Now you're just telling all these kids how to get high. You're just
Listen, I was told by the news. I'm just reporting it.
Don't do bath salt.
Yeah. If your kids come home with bath salt all of a sudden, something's going on.
They're not soaking in the tub.
That's right.
Epsom salt. Mm-hmm. Prices of Epsom salt's going to go up now.
Well, getting back to the story about the identity theft, a few weeks ago, didn't you have a problem with your credit card being stolen?
Yeah, somebody stole my credit card. Well, they stole the numbers off my credit card somehow, and through the investigation that I decided to go investigate myself, because half the time you never find out. That's what I do.
Mm-hmm.
I actually got the address for the merchant who supposedly charged my card, and it was for a cleaning service for $1,610. And I don't own a mansion or an airplane, so I couldn't understand what they said they cleaned for $610. So when I called, they gave me the address that was
$1,610, and then you said $610.
I said $1,610. Pay attention.
But you just said $610.
Pay attention. No,
I am.
Rewind.
We'll
all right.
You
well.
Did say $600.
Thank
all
you.
Right, well, everybody's against me now, so whatever. It was $1,610. I'll show you the bill. So anyway, they gave me the address, so I go to the address, and it's a house. It wasn't even a business.
Right.
And there was no one home, thank God, because who knows, they might have killed me or something. I don't know what I was thinking. But I called and called and called after I got the number, and I found out all this information about the people that live there. And I called and spoke to the woman, and she was basically really upset and said that it's probably her daughter's friend, and you know, gave me more information about the names. I took that to the police, called my credit card company back, and they said,
just ratting people out like that?
I'm not. Yeah, well, I told her, I said, look, I said, even if you don't have nothing to do with it, you could still go to jail. So you better give up the tapes on whoever's doing this using your address and phone number. So, but I'm not responsible for paying for it, but it's still pisses me off that somebody stole it. But in the end, what I was told is that there's these new scanners that you can get on eBay for like $10. Mm-hmm. And if somebody walks by you, they can scan your pocketbook or your wallet.
Why are you telling people how to scam people now? Why are you bringing that up?
Well, basically, I'm doing it to protect people from it because there's some kind of chip in the credit cards now that when you walk through the store, you could just scan it and you pay real fast.
Yeah, well, they have it at the pay pumps.
Right, and it's supposed to be convenient for people, but it's allowing other people to steal your information. So make sure if you have that chip in your card, call your credit card company and ask if there's a chip in there. You can protect yourself by wrapping it in aluminum foil and take it out and look like a unwrapping your credit card. Or you can buy a stainless steel wallet
or
that
lead,
they're selling.
A lead wallet.
Yeah, and that's the only way, I guess, to protect yourself. And if you get shot at, it'll protect you too if you have a lead wallet. Just stick it in your
wallet. You can just pay by cash and you'll never have a fucking problem.
True, but I use credit cards to make money. Okay. I make my. That's another tip. If you get a Citibank or Discover, you get cash back for everything you buy.
Well, that went towards that $1,600 you were scamming.
You can get 5% on gas right now, which is great.
Well, as we're saying, crime, of course, is getting worse due to the economy. And in a time span of 2 weeks, in the 4th District, the 2nd District, 7th and 8th and 15th District, there has been at least 36 robberies, 125 burglaries, and 458 thefts, which include residential businesses and cars.
What is the difference between thefts and robberies and burglaries?
I guess you have to wear a mask. Thefts, you just steal. And what was the other one? Robberies is like with a gun or a knife or something. I guess that's how they do it, but it's going to get worse.
Yeah. I think it's going to be a lot of like white collar men out there struggling to feed their families out.
Why has it got to be white and black then?
It's not black, it's
you
blue
said
and white.
You said white.
It's white and blue.
You brought it up.
You have no idea because you never worked a day in your life. So you wouldn't know white, blue, green. You have no
idea. Speaking of that, what's going on in Holmesburg?
Holmesburg? they're starting a new prison system to alert neighbors if there's been an escape. And they're going to sound an alarm. And you're going to hear it like a mile away in all directions. And they're going to like do a test every single, I think, the first Friday of every month. Mm. And it's going to sound really loud. So when you hear that, check and see if it's on a Friday. Because if not, that means there's a prisoner on the loose.
See if you see somebody in an orange suit running down the street.
Do they wear orange?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. So if you live around that area, listen for that sound.
Ring the alarm.
Ring the alarm. And if there's a reward, go on a manhunt. You can call 686-8345 or go to the website at readynotifypa.org for more information.
Or you can call the right number, which is 685-8345.
Did I say 686?
Yes, you did.
I'm so used to 686.
Well, the president of the Frankfurt Civic Association, Brian Wisniewski, wants to hear what residents have to say at the group's April 7th meeting regarding the bridge, which is a program for kids with mental health and drug problems. They now lease space from the Medical Mission Sisters on Pine Road and Fox Chase, so I guess they're getting kicked out of that area.
They need more room for the nuns.
Yeah, sure.
That's what they said.
They want to build on 9 acres of vacant land on the 1100 block Adams Ave. Wisniewski wondered why the Civic Association should support what he called a minimum security juvenile prison. And given their opposition to any more drug rehabilitation facilities in the neighborhood, which has been coming up a lot, members have maintained that Frankfurt is already home to scores of either drug rehabs or housing for recovering addicts.
True.
And he said, I can't see how we can go for something which we've been fighting against for so long. He said that at his March 3rd meeting. And the Frankfurt Civic Association's next meeting will be 7 p.m. on Thursday, April 7th. It's on the second floor conference room of the Aria Health's Frankfurt campus, which is on 4900 block of Frankfurt Avenue.
Yeah, well, hopefully people show up and have their voice
heard.
People
usually don't, though.
Well, they should, unless they want another.
But they don't, and then they complain.
Right. That's why we're telling them that there's a meeting, because probably nobody even knows about it at this point. Yeah. So anyway, there's like a health alert out there that I wanted to warn people about. You know, we are all known in Philly for having stomachs of steel because we eat off of the carts and get pinchos and pretzels off the guy that pisses on the side of the road.
And Scrapple TV.
Scrapple. And, you know, we have that 10-second rule when you drop the food and you...
Yeah, and kiss it up to God.
Kiss it up to God.
That's right.
Well, I've been reading a lot about shrimp. 2/3 of the shrimp consumed worldwide are caught in the ocean, but the rest is all farm-raised. And almost all of it is developed in countries like Thailand, Vietnam, Indonesia, China, Ecuador.
But have you saw the price of shrimp lately? It's real high.
Yeah.
And we were just saying how everybody's broke, so I don't think anybody's going to have a problem eating shrimp.
Well, you should
not in Kensington
about
anyway.
Shrimp.
Ain't nobody eating shrimp in Kensington.
Most people don't even know it, but there are serious problems, and it's, you know, it's bad because in these countries they don't have the same.
The same water they drink.
Yeah, pretty much. But we can't really get shrimp here since the Gulf spill, the oil spill, and everything like that.
Disaster.
So we have problems with the shrimp here. So with these other countries, there's like bacterial and viral diseases mm-hmm. in their waters. And like they have been using some antibiotics and chemicals and stuff like that to try to contain it, but it's not really working. So scientists are worried that with the antibiotics, they're going to develop like different disease resistance.
Mm-hmm.
Pathogens
right.
and stuff like that. So that's really scary because, you know.
What did you say, pathogens?
Yeah.
It just sounds weird hearing you say like educational, like you know what you're talking about. Just weird
you. Anyway, you know, whatever. He so gets on my nerves. Buyer beware because, you know, you are responsible for yourself. You're your own advocate. So check out where your store gets their shrimp from, especially like where you eat, like restaurants. They're all getting it cheap. So they're getting it overseas, third world countries and stuff like that. I'm not telling you don't eat shrimp because I don't want to be sued like Oprah for the meat. But I'm just saying, like, just watch where you get your shrimp from. And you can ask your local supermarket where they get it from.
Well, if you're trying to target the people in our area, you can't say shrimp. You have to say scrimp.
Well, I think people where
scrimp.
We grew up, we all just ate pretzels and ketchup. And that's what we called
shrimp. Was.
I didn't know what shrimp was until I was older.
I thought it was a short person.
Pretzels dipped in ketchup, man. Tastes like shrimp. Poor man.
Ham and macaroni and cheese every night at my house.
Oh,
I'm
so sick of hearing that. Okay, well, we have a new segment called Naughty Neighbors.
Naughty, naughty.
And we would like everybody to write in, email us, and let us know what your problem is with your neighbor.
About your up neighbors, because everybody has up neighbors.
Yeah.
I do.
Well, one of my best friends has a problem with her neighbor, Leanne Hammer.
Oh, yeah.
Leanne Doyle.
What's going on with her neighbor?
Abello DePasquale Hammer. Yeah.
What?
She has a lot of names. She lives at the 2500 block of Winchester.
You just gave her a dress and up and everything.
She wanted me to.
Wow.
I can show you where it is too on Google. Well, she just wanted to send out a to her neighbor because she's a real She parks so close to her wall where her driveway is that she can't even get her little skinny ass out of the car.
And what's her name? Leanne?
Yeah, she has to climb out like the
Leanne,
trunk
it might have been easier for you just to write a note, leave it on her windshield.
She told her face to face, and the lady still does it. Like, right. She put a wall up next to her driveway, and now.
Well, whoever the neighbor is, we know you watch this show, so just stop backing up on her bumper. Give her some face.
It's her driveway. She's allowed to park. The lady put a wall there. Anyway, move over. She wants her space back.
All right, here goes a complaint from Dawn Urbanski Martinez. She lived on a 600 block of Hilton Street, which is a wonderful block. Well, since 1995, she's had a real problem with her neighbors. There are three Mexican families in one house.
Wow.
Who live next door and who think it's time to party and blast music from 12 a.m. to around 6 a.m. She called the cops, nothing was done. She called L&I, they've been out. The landlord keeps switching the owner's name, blah, 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 blase, blaza. And she finally got some results from Pico after calling for over a year about them stealing electric. I don't condone ratting, so I don't like that thing right there.
They got it made. Three families, one house.
Still
no electric bill.
Them. You take care
they
of it.
They party every
if
night.
If you're a Kenzo, you take care of it in your own way. You don't call the cops. You don't call Pico. That's
well, at least we know where to go if we're looking for a party at midnight.
Right. Well, her street's always been a tight block. Flower pots, clean. What Exactly. That wasn't in 94. She lived there since 95. This wasn't like
I lived there back in 89, 90.
Yeah, and it was bad then.
At any rate, where do you really live?
She says it's quickly going downhill. How much further downhill can it get? And it's pretty scary, but she refuses to leave. She was born and raised there.
Yeah, but she's becoming, from like Mayfield.
Yeah, it's becoming very frustrating, she said. So she's forced to get revenge by blasting her own music in the daytime when the Mexicans are on their siestas. Kenzo style.
Dawn, just move. You don't need to put up with that.
Burn them out of house, that's all.
So over the weekend, Richie had his 49th birthday celebration.
My 29th.
Yeah, okay.
All right, I'll meet you in between. It was my 39th birthday.
Whatever. You just act like you're 49.
But we do have clips for those who didn't attend. We have clips to show you what it was about.
What
was,
you missed.
It was pretty fun.
You missed Charlie Sheen.
He didn't show up, but he was supposed to appear, but he didn't show up.
He was supposed to.
But anyway, enjoy the clip of
Well,
why
are we going to talk about why Charlie Sheen was supposed to be there?
Oh, okay. Yeah, we'll talk about that.
Before we show the clip?
Well, before the party, there was a rumor going around. Somebody made up a rumor that Charlie Sheen was supposed to show up at the party.
Aren't you the one who made up the rumor?
I might have been drinking it. I probably was drunk already.
So you fooled the media.
I fooled them. They were all the down there. It was so funny. They would not move from 9 o'clock at night till 2 a.m. till the bar closed. They would not move.
So they really believed that you were that important that Charlie Sheen was coming to your birthday party.
Why not? Why wouldn't they believe it? Richie Antipuna over here.
Oh, my God. You better ask someone who knows.
That's right. If you don't know, you better ask somebody. Mm-hmm. Well, they were all the fuck out there. Daily News, Infamous Magazine, Channel 3, Channel 29, Channel 17. They're all out there waiting, and I got over on you.
And they're mad at
but
you
But I
now.
Know it won't happen again, probably.
Yeah, next week. Who's coming? Flavor Flav?
Obama.
Oh, Obama.
Yeah.
You're so
Obama's
famous.
Obama's coming to my house.
So famous from your little TV show now. We're moving to California.
All right, well, enjoy the clip.
I'm hardcore, straight up raw. I'm the overlord, I door clocking. But no, as if you didn't know, fronting on the scene when it's time to go. Asking for a number from any member of the Tough Crew band. Remember, jacking on my tip, over tipping my shoulder. I'll be a soldier, a team roller, smashing those who stand in my path. Counting them down like math, planning, mapping, rapping them down for my part of town.
Girl.
Hope you enjoyed the clip. I had a great time. Sorry you missed it. And if you were there, thanks for stopping by.
And I'm not responsible for anything that happened that night.
And now it's time for the Community Corner.
Community Corner.
So what's going on with the Community Corner this week?
Well, you know, our good friend Taya.
Yes.
Her brother's wife's brother, I believe it is.
Well, why don't you just say her brother-in-law?
Well,
it's her brother's
wife, brother-in-law.
Cousin, sister's roommate in college, his janitor's
anyway,
mom.
They're having a fundraiser for him. It's Hip to Help because he has a degenerate bone disease called leg calf perthes. I'm not sure really how to pronounce that.
I like when you try to pronounce like fancy words, though.
How's it fancy? It's just not... Shut up. Anyway, it's the same disease that affected Bo Jackson. And
Bo? You know Bo?
Yeah. No, Boo, your friend. He's 16 years old. He's a sophomore at Father Judge, and he was diagnosed with this disease when he was about 5. And since then, he's had a lot of operations and stuff to try to correct this. They cleared him in 05 and said that he would be fine and he could do whatever he wanted. So he joined the track team. He's a wrestler. He came in first place in the city and 8th in the state for the Penn Relays. He's a good athlete. And he won the Best Novice Wrestler Award his freshman year.
Novice?
So.
What the f***? Novice.
Why do I not pronounce anything
novice,
right? Leave me alone.
I'm sorry. I thought I was being misinformed for a second.
He's an honors student, and he ranked 88 in a class of 278. So now the doctors just came back and told him that, you know, his problem's up again. He's going to need another surgery. His mom just lost his job. He's in a wheelchair using crutches. So they really need some help. So if you can get out and come to this benefit, it would be really appreciated from his family and friends. And if not, you can even send a donation. So
we'll have all that information at the
end of the show. We'll put that at the end of the show, how to contact it. Or you can go onto the Facebook, Richie Antipuna Show, and I'll put the information up there to tag it to that. And it's going to be tickets are $30 or $35 at the door. So it's not really that much money to put out.
Not
to
like sound like we're making fun. I just love when she doesn't speak English.
Your mother don't speak English.
Just like I noticed you said, his mother lost his job. But I don't pay attention.
You don't pay attention to stuff you're supposed to pay attention to. Worry about your own scripts, okay?
Well, what's next?
I don't know. Why don't you pay attention and read what's next?
Is this me?
Yeah.
Now listen, see if I make any mistakes.
All right.
Well, the Cora Women's Center at 2439 Kensington Avenue is a place women can go for free HIV testing. Music?
Mm-hmm.
Free IV testing music. Free IV HIV testing music. Fellowship or a cup of coffee. On the third Wednesday of every month, Pastor Frank Vegas' inner city missions hopes some of the women who pop in will allow him.
You said Vegas.
What is his name?
Vega.
Well, why is it spelled Vegas? I said Vegas.
You did not. You said Vegas.
Oh, boy. Well, anyway, he hopes any of the women that pop in will allow him or his staffers to steer them toward treatment, health care, housing, and other good stuff. They can have coffee, talk to one another, get counseling, get some resources, bags, which contain toothpaste, toothbrush,
you don't have to read it all. Kleenex,
I ain't, and other toiletries.
Hygiene products.
Yeah, and although they're not included in the bags, they do have feminine hygiene items available also.
Good to know.
So get down there and get your Kotex. They're always in need of donations, though, so feel free to drop off any of those items.
I will. Okay, so for Family Fun Day this week, I don't have a clue what to do with your kids. Sorry, just didn't have the time to look it up, and we had a long show today. So, you know, just tell your kids to go out and play like my parents used to tell me when I was a kid.
Get the out of the house, that's right. We ain't allowed
to play hopscotch. It's going to be nice.
Get up and get out. Nobody in, nobody out.
Right. By the time you get out, everybody's going to be in, she'd say.
Mm-hmm.
Fixing my hair. Folding my pants. Doing my laces. Right. So go out and play this weekend. Play hopscotch, collect popsicle sticks.
Blah, blah, blah. Well, that's all we have for you this week. Thanks for tuning in. As always, this is the Richie Antipuna Show and Kenzo News.
Live, love, laugh.
Live, love, laugh.
Spending dough, wasting time on a so-called rhyme, a so-called rapper with a so-called beat. All that shit is weak. Stand, yo, tell me, man, I can't understand this dude and what we're coming to. What is wrong with you? What you trying to do? Yo, once again, the judge with the grudge, the jury with fury to stomp on your mug. Yes, of course, a rap course you take. Make no mistake, I called you a fake. BS walking, money is talking. I'll retaliate, but wait for the beat to come back in. Stop slacking off, cause I'm packing gyms. Clubs, jams, name them all. We bring down the wall. Cause I gotta be down for my part of town.
Yeah.